students, today we see unit 5, the cell. So in this lesson we learn cell. So what is cell and cell structure and types of cell, difference between animal and plant cell. So all the topics we learn clearly. So first we see introduction. So look at the pictures. Anything you observe? Is there any similarity between them? The first picture, a brick wall. So what is the basic building block of the wall? A single brick. So a used brick, we made a wall. So same like this, your body is composed of basic building blocks and the name is cell. So in the second picture, each one is called cell. So all living things are made up one or more cells. They are variety of cell types and they all have some common characteristics functions also. So what is the definition of cell? The cell is the basic structural and functional unit of every living organism. So what is that? The cell is the basic structural and functional unit of every living organism. So the cell is self-sufficient to carry out all fundamental and essential functions of an organism. So this is cell, and the cells are very minute, so we can't see with our naked eyes. So we can only observe through a specialized and scientific instrument. So the instrument name is microscope. So using microscope only we can see and observe the cells. Understood? So nowadays we use electron microscope. So this is the electron microscope. So in the first Robert Hooke only invented the first microscope. So he is only invented the first microscope. So the microscope name is compound microscope. So this is the compound microscope. He placed a water lens beside the microscope to focus the light from an oil lamp, so on specimen, to illuminate them brightly so that he was able to see the minute parts of objects clearly. So we use a microscope, we can see the minute parts of the objects. So Hooke also published a book that named Micrographia. So in the year 1665. So he only used the term cell. So in first, Robert Hooke only used the term cell. So he described the structure of tissue using the term cell. So that word cell derived from Latin word cellula. So that means small chamber. So understood? So the study of cells is called cell biology. So it's a one of the branch of the science. So study of cells is called cell biology. So next topic, structure of the cell. So the typical cell consists of three major parts. How many parts? Three major parts. First one, cell membrane. So this is the outer part. And second one, a liquid cytoplasm. So third one, nucleus. First one, cell membrane. Second one, cytoplasm. Third one, nucleus. So this is the major parts of the cell. So next one, size of the cell. So the size of cell may vary from a micrometer to centimeter. So the smallest size of the cell. So the smallest organism is bacteria, right? So the smallest size of the cell is present in bacteria only. The size of the bacterial cell ranges from 0.01 micrometer to 0.5 micrometer. So the largest cell is the egg of an ostrich. So this is the largest organism. So the egg of an ostrich with 170 millimeter width. So that cell we can see our naked eye. So the nerve cells, the human body, the nerve cells also the longest cell. Understood? So something learned new. The cell size has no relation to the size of an organism. So the cell size has no relation to the size of organism, because elephant is a big organism, right? So that cell is big. The mouse is a small organism, so that cell is very small. Don't like this. The cell size has no relation to the size of an organism. Understood? Next topic, shapes. So cells are not same shapes. So there are different shapes is there. So the first one, nerve cell. Second one, red blood cell. So third one, muscle cell. So they are different shapes. Okay. The number of cells present in different organism may vary. That means the count of cell is different. So organism may be either unicellular or multicellular. So unicellular means it has single cell only. So example, bacteria, amoeba, chlamydomonas and yeast are unicellular. Second one, multicellular organisms such as Spirogyra, mango and human beings all have multicellular. So it made up of few hundreds to million of cells. So in human body, the number of cells is 3.7 into 10 power 13. So it the example for multicellular. So next topic, ranges of cell size. So from small to large, a small organism. First one is virus. So next, bacterium cell. So third, planet cell. Fourth, egg of human. So fifth one, frog cell. So sixth one, hen's egg. And the large organism, so the last one, ostrich egg. So this is a range of cell size. So next topic, size types of cell. So cells are classified into two types. So first one, prokaryotic cell, and second one, eukaryotic cell. So it has prokaryotic cells has no true nucleus. So it has two types. First one is bacteria and cyanobacteria. So eukaryotic cells have true nucleus, and it has two types, plant cell and animal cell. So first we see prokaryotic cell. So a unicellular organism like bacteria has prokaryotic cell. So unicellular organism is called prokaryotic cell, and it has no nucleus. This type of nucleus is called nucleoid. This type of nucleus is called as nucleoid. So no nuclear membrane, and around is nucleoid. So no nuclear membrane. So in the prokaryotic cell, so the cell were the first form of life on the earth. So it's ranging 0.003 to 2.0 micrometer in diameter. So this is the prokaryotic cell, and its part, a chromosome, a flagellum, outer membrane, inner membrane. So this is the parts of the prokaryotic cell. So next one, eukaryotic cell. So the cell which has true nucleus is called eukaryotic cell. So it is a bigger than prokaryotic cell, and its organelles are bounded by a membrane. So example, plants, animals, most of the fungi. Okay, so this is the eukaryotic cell, and it parts ribosome, cell membrane, a mitochondrion membrane, enclosed nucleus and nucleus. So this is the parts of the eukaryotic cell. And next one, difference between prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. So prokaryotic cell, first point, is the diameter ranges from 1 to 2 micron. Eukaryotic cell diameter ranges 10 to 100 micron. So this is a bigger one. So second point, absence of membrane, bounded organelles. So is there no membranes? So eukaryotic cell, it presence of membrane, bounded organelles. So third point, nucleus is not surrounded by a nuclear membrane. So nucleus is not surrounded by nuclear membrane. So here two nucleus is surrounded by the nuclear membrane. So the last point, nuclei, absence and presence of nuclei. Understood? So the next point, plant cell. So plant cell. So this is the plant cell, and it is usually larger in size, and it is hard in nature also. And plant cells have a cell wall in addition to their cell membrane. So plant cell have chloroplasts which contain chlorophyll. So plant cell have large vacuoles, centrioles are absent. So this is a plant cell, and this part, Golgi apparatus, chloroplast, nucleus, nucleolus, endoplasmic reticulum, cell wall and mitochondria. This is the parts of the plant cell. And the next one, animal cell. So animal cells are generally smaller than plant cell. It is not so hard as plant cell. So cell wall is absent, chloroplast is absent. So animal cell may have many small vacuoles. Centrioles are found in animal cells. So this is the animal cell, and this part, mitochondria, centrioles and Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum, nucleus, nucleolus, cytoplasm, plasma membrane. So this is a part of the animal cell. So the next one, three dimension. So cell structure. So cell is a three dimensional pictures. So what is three dimensional? So for example, you draw a ball. So how do you draw? So you draw one circle, right? So this is a two dimensional picture. So you draw the spherical shape only, it's called three dimensional picture. So the animal cells are spherical shape only, not a round shape. So this is called three dimensional picture. So a cell structure have three dimensional. So this is the cell structure, and it parts cell membrane, nucleus, nucleolus, cytoplasm and mitochondrion, Golgi complex and endoplasmic reticulum. So this is the parts of the cell. Understood? So the last topic, cell components and the function. So first one, cell wall. So that function surrounds and protects the cell, make the cell stiff and strong. So that special name, supporter and protector. So second component, cell membrane. It function holds and protects the cell, controls the movement of the material in and out of the cell. So the special name, gate of the cell. Third one, cytoplasm, a watery gel like a material in which cell parts move. So the special name, area of movement. Fourth one, mitochondria. So its function, produce and supply most of the energy to the cell. So special name, powerhouse of the cell. So powerhouse of the cell is called mitochondria. Next, fifth one, chloroplast. So it contain green pigment chlorophyll. So capture the energy of sunlight and use it to produce food for the cell and by photosynthesis. So last unit we see what is photosynthesis, right? So the special name of chloroplast, a food producer for the cell. Next, vacuoles, it functions store food and water and chemicals. So special name, storage tank. Storage tank is called vacuoles. Nucleus acts as brain of the cell. Nucleus acts as brain of the cell, regulates and control all the cell activities. Those special name, control center. Next, nucleus membrane. It function surrounds and protects the nucleus, control the movement of the materials in and out of the nucleus. The special name, gate of the nucleus. So I hope all understood, right? The lesson is over. We see a small recap. Okay, so cells, what is cell? Cells are the basic units of living organism. Cells are the basic units of all living organism. So what are the major parts? So there are two major cell types, such as first one, prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. So both plant and animal cells have unique organelles, so which are capable of carrying out specialized function. So last point, the plant cells have two unique components such as cell wall and chloroplast. So compared to animal cells. So plant cells have two unique components. First one, cell wall, and chloroplast. So understood all of you? I hope all of you understood. So thank you for watching this video. Thank you.